There are no financial disclosures in the subject matter of the film. How do we protect generalized zonulopathy? A thorough preoperative evaluation by asking the patient's history is essential. Clinically, slit lamp evaluation can reveal phacotonisis, pseudoexfoliation. Often, there is associated shallow anterior chamber depth and small pupil due to inadequate holding back of the crystalline lens because of zonulopathy. Any shallow anterior chamber depth with normal axial length should raise a strong suspicion to weak zonules. After evaluation, despite understanding the progressive or non-progressive nature of zonulopathy, the surgeon can still have intraoperative surprise. A smooth sea never made a skillful sailor. This video is a stepwise approach towards different case scenarios of generalized zonulopathy and their management. A long tunnel of the primary incision is preferred to avoid anterior chamber fluctuations, which can in turn cause stress to the zonules. Additionally, long tunnel side port incision using a 25 gauge needle calibrated to the shape and size of the instruments further helps in anterior chamber stability. Triamcinolone acetate is used to ascertain the presence of vitreous in the anterior chamber. Intracameral epinephrine is used to dilate the pupil. Sometimes a highly retentive ophthalmic viscosurgical devices can also help in dilating the pupil and keeping the chamber stable. However, a non-dilating pupil should require the use of a pupil dilating aid like a Malugin ring in this case. Invariably, the lens moves because of decreased countertraction by zonules. A sharp cystitome can be used to create the initial nick. A halo sign too indicates zonulopathy which requires the use of cystitome. Other methods to initiate include double pinch method by two needles, use of radio frequency tip, applying femtosecond laser assisted capsulorhexis, employment of Fugo blade, and the use of septorhexis procedure. Sizing of rhexis is important. A large rhexis should be planned as the compromised centrifugal force exerted by weak zonules can predispose to capsular contraction syndrome and IOL capsular bag complex subluxation or dislocation later on. Large rhexis also helps to bring the nucleus out of the capsular bag, thereby decreasing risk of zonular stress. Bimanual rhexis can be done too in zonulopathy to complete the rhexis. Here, the second forceps provides countertraction. Capsular hooks can be used as artificial zonules to immobilize the bag and help complete the rhexis by providing countertraction. Multiple quadrants hydrodissection helps to loosen the corticocapsular adhesions. Rotation can be tried by bimanual method. It can also be tried using capsular supporting aids. Capsular hooks are preferred because they function as artificial zonules by providing anterior posterior capsular support right up to the equator, unlike the iris hooks which provide only vertical capsular support. Low fluid parameters and low IOP should be used to provide stable anterior chamber settings and prevent sudden deepening or collapse of anterior chamber. The method of choice for nuclear emulsification is chopping. Slow motion phacoemulsification is preferred. Rotation of nucleus should be attempted only when capsular hooks have supported the bag. Forceful rotation should not be attempted. Nuclear pieces are chopped, totally separated, and left in situ to provide scaffolding, thereby decreasing the tendency for the bag to collapse. These voluminous hard nuclear fragments help in providing three-dimensional support to the capsular bag. The nuclear fragments should be brought out of the bag into the center and emulsified to decrease stress on zonules. The capsular hooks provide advantage of delaying the insertion of CTR. CTR should be inserted before removing capsular hooks to prevent stress on zonules. In cases with minimal zonulopathy, as in Morgagnon cataracts with hard nuclear fragments where high fluidics are used, there can be a BCR or bag emulsification post-occlusion. Here, the last nuclear fragment is brought out of the bag into the interior chamber and then IOL is implanted in the bag. At this stage, IOL acts as a scaffold and protects the posterior capsule and the bag. A stable interior chamber is maintained to decrease stress on zonules at the end of the emulsification by keeping the bag inflated with OVD. Otherwise, there can be stress to the zonules and zonular dehiscence with sudden collapse of the interior chamber. Despite viscous separation of cortical lamellas, tangential stripping of cortical lamellas is done for cortex removal. With difficult cortical removal, reverse stripping can be done as well for cortex removal. Interior capsular polishing is done to decrease late onset capsular contraction syndrome and late IOL back complex dislocation. It helps by decreasing the progressive centripetal force exerted by fibrotic capsular rim, thereby reducing zonular stress. At times, radial stria in the posterior capsule indicate weakness of zonules. The insertion of CTR can be done manually or with the injector. In the manual method, CTR should be directed towards the bag. The bag has to be adequately inflated and not overinflated. Once the leading eyelet is in the bag, the dialing is continued till more than half is in the bag. Before implanting the proximal eyelet, it is confirmed that the bag is still adequately inflated. With continued dialing of the CTR, 3/4 of CTR gets placed in the bag. At that stage, the proximal eyelet is held at the tip outside the primary incision and advanced in the bag by 3 o'clock hours away from the primary incision. CTR provides centrifugal horizontal force, making the flaccid capsular bag taut and allowing the stria to disappear. CTR can also be implanted through an injector slowly into the bag until the trailing eyelet becomes visible. With the support of Sinsky hook, in the bag implantation of CTR is ensured. Additionally, CTS can be used to fixate the bag to the sclera to prevent late IOL bag dislocation in progressive zonulopathy. Multi-piece IOL can be implanted in mild zonulopathy to provide better centrifugal support to the bag.